Hey babe. Mm-hmm. You ready to shoot the ship? Mm-hmm. Is this on?
Yes.
Are you drinking Arizona while you're watching yourself on repeat? No, turn the can. That I'm asking if that's what you're doing.
It might be what I'm doing.
I'm leaving. I was coming in here to be here with you.
You were supposed to help me with my bid.
No more. And I'm taking my coffee back. That's how you know I'm serious.
What? Come
you
back.
You enjoy that? You're so goddamn goofy. You are so fucking goofy.
I feel very discriminated against.
I'm coming back late. Let me know when you're done.
You always tell me how funny I am. Why can't I watch myself be funny?
You are so narcissistic.
That video is a classic. You know where you can watch that video over and over again? On fucking Twitter. Oh yeah, so while I'm like getting prepared for everything, somebody just sent me a video, you know who you are, on Instagram, and somebody, get out!
One more thing!
What?
Can we talk about how much Arizona we actually bought though? Can we just like talk about the fact that we bought so much? Okay,
sweet.
We're not getting paid for this.
That's not even all of the Arizona.
Oh, I drank the other ones.
What do you mean? There were like five other ones.
They were delicious.
Oh,
I love
it. Oh my god. What was I saying? Oh yeah, so somebody sent me a video on Instagram of their mom watching me do my weekly Twitter advice. Like, I think it's my most recent one. And first and foremost, like, thank you. Like, that's so cute. But also, like, oh my god, like, I cuss a lot. After I realized, like, people, like, have their moms and families, like, watch my videos, I was like, oh my, I need to wash my mouth out with soap. Like, the number of times I say dick is high. So, I'm gonna try really hard during this weekly Twitter advice to not say the word dick so much. And to assist me in that, Chavez is going to put up a dick counter. But it's not gonna start till we start the questions, because otherwise I would have like been failed already. Anyway, Chavez is gonna put up a dick counter right here. So, let's go ahead and get started with question one. Got fired, so I started dating a wealthy local man. Reasonable response. I've done everything in my power to get money out of him, but he refuses. Finally, I gave him a few Valiums, access his bank account, and he's poor and renting everything he has. Pregnant by this bum motherfucker. Oh my god, girl. Congratulations. You played yourself. I am so... Oh, girl. Stupid. Why would you not verify his income before you did some dumbass shit like this? Like, I don't fucking understand. Y'all act like people don't be buying shit that they can't afford all the fucking time. Like, I don't know why you would look at the shit that people have and just assume like they can afford that shit. Like, so many people in the world are in debt right now because they're buying shit that they can't fucking afford, and you just assume like because he had nice shit that that somehow meant he had money. Like, that's dumb. Some of the like most bummy looking people in the world are rich as fuck. There's this dude who used to come into my old job when I worked in a casino, and that nigga literally looked fucking homeless. Like, he was like fucked up, hair fucked up, like, and that nigga was like a straight up millionaire. So, you're dumb. You're dumb, and I'm sorry you're dumb. I hope your baby's not as dumb as you are. Shit. I'm moving on to the next question, because I'm irritated. I ain't got no patience for this shit right now. Moving on to question. My attractive mother, stop. I am not reading the rest of the question till you look me in the eyes and fucking stop that shit. Stop it. Attractive mother-in-law is not a fucking phrase that should ever come out of your fucking mouth. I should have done a fuck counter instead of a dick counter. Guys. My attractive mother-in-law is seeking companionship and my friend would date her. No! I don't even need to finish the rest of this question. No! Why would you ever let your friend put his penis anywhere near your mom/mother-in-law? Absolutely not. Are you stupid? Like, huh? My wife is against it, but I think he'll keep her in good company. I mean, good on you for riding for your dudes. Okay. Finally, my wife blurted, my mama don't want no dick that big. Wait.
No dick that big.
Wait. I'm so sorry. I was so caught up on the... What? Then she said, he was too big for me at five... What? Excuse me? Yo, you can't end the question like that. I need more context. I need to know what happened. When was she fucking on your friend? And why didn't you already know about this? Or did you already know about this? In which case, why is your wife talking to you about it like this? Shit, and I gotta give you advice based on this shit? I don't fucking know, nigga. Why is your wife thinking about other dudes' dicks like this?
Other dudes' dicks like this.
And what, like, what does your wife know about what her mama wants in her vagina anywho's in? And my advice is don't let your friend fuck your wife's mom. And also tell your wife, I don't even know what to tell your fucking wife. Like, I really don't. I have zero fucking clue. I'm gonna go ahead and move on to pregunta número... Tres. Me and twin sister lived with our dad because mom had drug issues. Sad face. Dad met a younger woman and she told us to move out by June 1st on our birthday. He is just going along with it. We're only in our 30s and don't have much to live good on our own. Ma'am! I thought you were gonna say like we're like we just turned 20 and bitch, y'all are in your 30s and still using your mama's drug issues as an excuse to leech off your daddy. No fucking wonder his new wife was sick of it. She was like, oh hell no, my man is not about to be out here paying for his grown ass daughters to sit around and be fucking bums. Bitch, if y'all don't get the fuck up and get yourself jobs, your mama had drug issues, but do you? No? You fine? Are you good? Can you work? Because if you can't work, your ass should be working. It's different if you can't work. If your mama's drug issues somehow led to an inability on your part or your sister's part to work, that's different. But that's not what it sounds like. What it sounds like is you and your sister have been sitting around feeling sorry for yourselves that your mama hasn't been around. And you ain't been doing nothing to help your dad out at all. So he's just been picking up, not only has he been picking up your mama's slack because she been gone, but now you're grown and he should be able to relax and live his fucking life and you won't let this nigga get gray hair in peace. Shit. Let this man live his fucking life, dude. What is wrong with y'all? Fuck. My advice is to get a fucking job, bum. And I normally don't talk to women like this. Wait. Is you a woman? Whatever. I'm gonna assume you and your sister are female twins and not, I said female twins, identical twins and not fraternal. So let's go ahead and move on to pregunta número cuatro with none of the theatrics because apparently my voice can't take it. These allergies are whooping my ass. Feeling lonely, I reconnected with my high school sweetheart. Sounds like a terrible idea, but okay. We quickly decided to get engaged. Definitely a terrible idea. Bad idea. She has two kids, no problem, but is a liar. Big problem. She said she was spending nights with her friend when that friend was spending nights with me and sir or ma'am. Why are y'all like this? Why do y'all do this to me on purpose? Cause at this point, I'm feeling like it's personal. Like y'all just enjoy stressing me the fuck out. Y'all just want to get my blood pressure up. I don't need you to get my blood pressure. I don't suffer from low blood pressure. Shit. First of all, why are you reconnecting with somebody that you were with in high school? Like, even though I know we all love those romantic stories of people who marry their high school sweethearts and stay together forever, let's be real, your high school sweetheart is your high school sweetheart for a fucking reason. Because you were one way in high school, and as you fucking grew up, you changed, you matured, and the relationship wasn't able to withstand the test of time. Right? Okay? That's why y'all split up. So, and you already said explicitly at the beginning of the sentence that you only got back together with her because you were feeling lonely. Like, what the fuck kind of bullshit is that? So, that's the first thing. Second of all, why would you quickly decide to get engaged, nigga? Marriage is not a quick thing. Marriage is supposed to be fucking permanent. So, how are you gonna go into marriage quickly? Like, who does that? And why? Who have you seen it work out for positively? Like in real life, not like, oh, well, on that one reality TV show, blah, blah, blah. Like, no, in real fucking life, who have you ever met who got engaged quickly and it worked out just fucking smashing for them? Because I guarantee you, it's less than fucking 10%, less than fucking 5% of the people that you know. I guarantee you. And of the 5% of the people that you know that got engaged quickly, I bet you less than half of those people are fucking actually happy. Like, come on, man. Put some actual, like, thought towards the future. See the big picture for, like, 2 fucking seconds. And then she has 2 kids. I mean, I would assume that it's not a problem because you fucking decided to marry her ass or whatever. But is a liar and says she was... So first of all, why are you spending nights with her friend? I don't understand. You're with this bitch. You decided to get engaged and now you're spending nights with her friend? That don't make no fucking sense. What? Huh? And second of all, if this bitch is lying to you about who she's spending the night with, then like... Y'all probably don't need to get married, and really, y'all don't need to be together at all. Go let this woman live her best life and stop sleeping with your girlfriend's friends. Like, shit. I'm tired of all y'all. Y'all getting on my goddamn nerves. And that's it. That's the last question for this fucking weekly Twitter advice. And make sure you tune in tomorrow to see part 2 of the weekly Twitter advice, which is where we see what Twitter has to say about these shenanigans. And I already know question 4 is gonna be just, the responses are just gonna be perfect, beautiful. All right, let's go. And a 3. Peace out, hope biscuits. It's getting lit. Hey, dick is dick summer. Dick counter. Dick. Big dicks.
It's 2 dicks in my pants for a nigga that's sick.